Macamagob, everybody. Hey, it's a donated episode. Nina, good friend of mine, super cool girl. She wanted me to do a suck versus suck episode. I know many of you love when I do it, especially you guys that actually agree with the album. But then there's many people that love these albums that I put suck versus suck that actually love hearing me complain about these albums they love, which, man, people like that are cool as hell. Unlike you pickle whistlers. So, I'm putting Look What the Cat Dragged In versus Open Up and Say Ah from Poison. And, so I took notes. Now, first of all, I have reviewed both these albums on my podcast, Rock and Metal Combat Podcast. And I also did, I believe, a track by track on this channel for Look What the Cat Drags In versus I forgot what. So I've heard these albums, but, you know, I never go back and revisit them. But I gotta say, man, and I've said this before, I said it on the podcast, I had so much fun. You know, usually when people donate for us to review albums on the podcast that I don't like, it's always a chore, and, you know, and I end up hating it more and stuff like that. And but Poison was a whole different story. Listening to the Poison album was just so much fun, and I love both these albums for all the wrong reasons. I mean, it's so bad. It's hysterical. I look at these albums as comedy albums. It's just like Richard Pryor and Cheech and Chong, you know, to me. But I know more people take it serious, and that's cool. You know, I mean, I'm not bashing you people that like this stuff, you know. But, I mean, I like a lot of stuff that people consider terrible. So, you know, big fan of Monster from Kiss. So, I know what it feels like, you people, to hear people bash on stuff you love. So, but it doesn't affect me as well. I'm kind of like those people I was talking about earlier that love to hear me bash stuff they love. I love to hear it too, you know. But anyway, let's get into this. What the fuck was that? Did you see that? All right, well, let's get into this. All right. First song is Cry Tough. How does one cry tough? That is a very, very, it's a mystery. I heard recently Clint Eastwood released a movie called Cry Macho. I need to see that movie because it'll explain the mystery to me, how one cries tough. All right, I took notes here. So, today I took a deep dive. I really did analyze the lyrics and everything. I'm telling you, man, going back and listening to Poison album, to me, it's fun. Because I love comedy. So there is a lyric on this where it says, "You gotta aim high, baby, whether you lose or win. Because when you get to the top..." Wait a second. If you lose or win, how are you gonna get to the top? I think it should have said, "You gotta aim high, baby, whether you lose or win, and if you get to the top, not when you get to the top." So, Bret Michaels, his lyrics were, you know, a little wrong there. How shocking. Alright, so that's going against Love on the Rocks. Holy shit. Generic as fuck, but, man, and I'm gonna play this little clip now. What Bret Michaels does on this song is just hysterical. Listen to this. Ooh, look it up. Let's hear that again. What the? Come on, that is some funny ass shit. Now, I gotta tell you something. Listening to Poison today, I thought to myself, you know, this band became huge. They were huge, and they played arenas, sold millions of albums. With this lack of musicianship, and really, I mean, these songs are terrible, but You know, I got to give it to them, though, because this, I got to respect Poison. I do. And I never thought of respecting them ever till today, because this is a band that made it with lack of everything. And why? Because, you know, that Cry Tough song, it's pretty much, you know, something that's lacking in music is, you know, go for your dreams and, you know, bust your ass and do it. And they did it, man. Whether I like their songs or not, I got to respect them for achieving the impossible. You know, to me, it's incredible. A band like this crappy, doing these crappy-ass songs, made it so big. So, you know, I got to hand it to them. And I'm going to give this one a Cry Tough, because at least it's a positive song. You know, even though I still don't know what Cry Tough means, but I hear the lyrics and it's like, you know, we're going to try hard and, you know, and very, you know, honest too. It's like when you get to the top, you fall right back down again. That's what happened to them, you know. When grunge came, they fell down. All right, so one for Look For What The Cat Drags In. Next is I Want Action. I mean, really bad. But, you know, again, I'm listening to these lyrics today, and there's a lyric. Wait, how did it go again? If I can't make her, I'll take her and make her. No, if I can't have her, if I can't have her, I'll take her and make her. Which is basically what I get out of that. It's about kidnapping a chick and raping her. Wow. And that one's going against Nothing But A Good Time. Yeah, terrible. But you know what? It's a party song. I get, you know, now, you know, older, I get it. You know, it's like, you know, I don't like the song, but, you know, the message is, let's have a good time. Let's party. Let's get laid. You know, and fuck integrity. Fuck musicianship. Let's just go out there and party and get laid. And, you know, I mean, it does nothing for me, but the message, like Cry Tough, don't like it, but the message wins it. So I think the message of this is it's better to party, drink, rap to a chick, get her into bed willfully, instead of, you know, kidnapping a chick and raping her. So I'm going to give that one to Nothing But A Good Time. All right, what's next? I Won't Forget You, Baby. The Token power ballad, schlop, lock. And I watched that video today, and the beginning of it was CeCe on the phone. Hey, baby, yeah, sweetheart, I miss you. It's like, holy fuck, it doesn't get cheesier than that. That one's going against Back to the Rockin' Horse. More generic, no talent by numbers type song. It's shit. But it does have the comedy factor where he goes, I'm gonna get back. Let's listen to that. As a matter of fact, I just don't wanna get back. I'm back to the rocking horse. That's just so funny. Get back. So I guess I'll give it to that, because at least it made me giggle. Alright, what's next? Oh, the infamous Play Dirty. This is the one where we really goofed on the podcast, because it has a line in the song where it's like, take it outside, because the song is them hanging out at, Jimmy's Bar and Grill. And they're hanging out there playing pool, and I guess, you know, they get in a scuffle. So he tells the guy, take it outside. And that became a running joke on the podcast. Take it outside. And I don't know, man. I mean, the way Poison looked at the time, going to Jimmy's Bar and Grill, I don't think it's wise for them to take it outside. Because Jimmy's Bar and Grill, I picture a bunch of bikers that would just love to either beat their ass or fuck them. All right, what's that going against? Oh, Good Love. This one, listen to the beginning of the song. This shit cracks me up. Oh man, but the ending is even funnier. Listen to what Bret Michaels does at the end of this song. Oh, damn. Fuck. Fucking A. Let's hear that again. That's some funny shit, man. I'm gonna give it to Good Love for that. I mean, it takes talent to do these weird noises with your mouth. Fuck that was. Let's hear that again. Alright, what's next? Look what the cat dragged in. Generic. But you know what? I mean, it's mildly passable. As, you know, kind of like, you know, it's kind of the moment. The generic riff. There's a million riffs like that. And, you know, with the lyrics like, I got it. I got two chicks in the left of me, two chicks in the right. I don't know where I slept last night. Oh, man. What's that going against? Tear Down the Walls. I mean, this song, there's nothing funny about it. This one's just bad. So I'll give that one to Look What the Cat Drags In. All right, next is Talk Dirty to Me. It's a ripoff of She's Tight. And it was the song that exploded the band. I remember seeing Poison. I saw Poison back in 85 in Los Angeles at a place called, I think it was called Madame Wong. Anybody out there from California, LA looking at me, remember Madame Wong? And I remember seeing that show, and there was a bunch of chicks there, and there was Silly String. They had Silly String and stuff. And I do have somewhere, I believe, the flyer to that. The flyer was actually green. I think I have it, or maybe I threw it away. But I don't remember what the hell they played that night. But, you know, it was all original stuff, but it was a really bad show. I left that one going, ugh. I saw a lot of good shows while I was there. I saw Odin. I know Odin gets made fun of a lot because of that metal movie, the metal Years. Would you stop doing that? That shit's really making me cringe. Anyway, the Odin, I love that first EP. It's called Don't Take No for an Answer. That was a good show. I saw AC/DC with Yngwie Malmsteen at the LA Forum. I saw Guns N' Roses at the Troubadour. And I found out later it was the very first time they ever played Paradise City, which was October of 1985. I saw some cool shit while I was there. But I also saw Poison. All right, so Talk Dirty to Me. Wow. It's just bad. CeCe, pick up that guitar and talk to me. And that one's going against Look But Can't Touch. This song sucks so bad, but I'm going to give it to this one because of this comedic section of the song. What the hell was that? Brr, yowza. Fucking terrible. But wins. All right, next is Want Some, Need Some. The generic is strong on this tune. Pretty shitty. And, you know what? I haven't picked an album. Let's pick something good from my collection to talk about for a second before I get into, maybe we're past side two, but let's go right here. Oh, man. Not that good. And you all know what I feel about David Lee Roth. I love Dave, you know? But after Eat 'Em and Smile, this to me was a disappointment. But you know what my favorite song is on here? Is Two Fools Born a Minute. I know it's silly and stupid. Hina's pretty cool. I love the solo on that. Knuckle Bones, Bottom Line. But really, I let's pick something good. Let's talk about something good on it. Let's go over here. All right. Oh, man, what the hell's going on? This is terrible. Sergeant Pepper. But you know what I like on here is Got to Get You Into My Life by Earth, Wind, and Fire, and the Aerosmith song Come Together. I do like on this. Let's try this again. Let's go down here. Come on, man. Something good. Oh, I love this one. First Vandenberg album. Kick-ass stuff, man. Back on My Feet, Love Is in Vain, Wait, Burning Heart was kind of like the hit. The whole album, man. Ready For You, Too Late, Nothing in the City, Nothing to Lose, Lost in the City. All right, now we can get back to it because I picked something good for once. Three times a charm, right? All right, where are we? It was like Want Some, Need Some. All right, then that's going against Fallen Angel. You know, I'm not a fan of this song. I don't like it. But again, I watched the video today, and that chick in the video is hot. So I'm going to give it to that song because of that chick. All right, what's next? Blame It On You. This is a song that it starts with, I wrote some lyrics off this. It's just hilarious. She's got pizzazz like a razzmatazz. And what's the next one? I need a little reaction. I need a kiss or two. She said, jump back, honey. I said, no can do. Why do you always make a fool of me? I can't get no nookie, just plain to see. Holy crap, that's funny. I don't know about you, but that is in my wheelhouse of comedic gold. I almost said comedic genius, but come on, that's pushing it. All right, so what's that going against? Every Rose Has Its Thorn. Woo! Yeah, that one's the token power ballad. I believe it went to number one on the charts, actually. And I'm listening to that today, and that those backing vocals on it, it goes, well, I wonder, will she go, who the fuck okay to, hey, it worked though, it went to number one, so what do I know? What's that going against? Number one, Bad Boy. Now, I gotta tell you something, this is like the third, fourth time I heard this, and I gotta say, man, it's not good, but it's fair, and fair to me makes it the greatest Poison song ever, you know? What you heard about me is probably right, ta. Well, I heard he sucks, so I know that's right. But, you know what? It's the best Poison song I ever heard. I haven't heard any other albums after this. I've heard on Skinny Bop and some other crappy songs, but what's that going against? Your Mama Don't Dance. Let me tell you something. I'm a 70s kid. The 70s ruled, man. All the pop music of the 70s, everything of the 70s ruled for me, man. But there are exceptions. And I remember hearing this song when I was a little kid, Your Mama Don't Dance. And it's a crappy song, even for the 70s. Out of every song, they picked that one to do. So which one do I'm giving it to? I'm giving it to, obviously, number one, Bad Boy, since I think it's the greatest Poison song ever. And, you know, I hate saying greatest and poison at the same time, on the same sentence. So now we're going to the final songs. And I gotta say, man, Let Me Go to the Show is the funniest Poison song I've heard yet. I mean, this is gold, how fucking hilarious this song is. Let me recite some lyrics on here. It's a song, I will go into the meaning of the song. The meaning of Let Me Go to the Show is Brett wanting to go to a show because to see those bad boys playing that rock and roll, but his mom wouldn't let him go. I can identify with that. You know, I miss Black Sabbath with Van Halen because my mom and dad wouldn't let me go. And also Kiss on the Love Gun tour, Van Halen 2 tour, all shows I couldn't see, but my parents didn't let me go to the show. I wanted to see those bad boys playing that rock and roll. But look at this lyric, man. At the end, you know, he keeps saying, Mama, let me go to the show. I want those bad boys playing that rock and roll. And then at the end, it goes, Mama, let me go to the show. And then Mama comes in saying, no way. No way, son. N-O. That's fucking genius. And then, genius? Did I just say genius? Am I high? All right, I gotta admit. I did inject cat tranquilizers in my eyeballs. But how else am I going to listen to Poison? You know, I need some kind of like intense stimulants. And then Papa, Mama won't let him go to the show. Then Papa comes in at the very end of the song and says, "You heard your mother, turn that shit off." I'm like, that is the greatest line. But, you know, the only disappointing thing of Papa saying, "Turn that shit off," is that he didn't say it halfway through the first song, "Cry Tough." You know, I could have been spared. Well, then again, I wouldn't have brought so much joy and laughter into my life if there was no "Look What the Cat Dragged In." And that one's going to get Bad to Be Good. What is good about this? There's nothing. It's not even funny. You know, it's just, you know, it's bad to be bad. I mean, how? There's nothing, it's the opposite, good and bad. I mean, this is just bad and bad. Anyway, so let's go now and look at the, look What the Cat Dragged In got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, where Open Up and Say All said 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, it's a tie. It's a tie of suckiness. What do y'all think of these two records right here? If you like them, well, obviously you like them because you know about them, unless you're like me and you like comedy albums. Put your track by tracks in the comments below. You know, for me, but anyway, so thank you so much, Nina, for the donation. And if you'd like to donate, I got a PayPal in the description below. And please subscribe to my channel if you haven't and click that little notification bell. Right on, everybody. Thank you for watching. Stay frosty. Listen to Black Sabbath. And smack 'em a gob. N-O.